Hey y'all, it's been a while since I have done a tutorial specifically on the Rev Slider, and I had an old tutorial about how to add buttons or create a custom button inside of the Rev Slider, and that tutorial is so out of date now that I've got to come do another one. I'm currently going to be doing this tutorial on version 5.2.6. As y'all know, when 5.0 rolled out, everything radically changed. This whole user interface looks completely different. So creating a custom button is a little bit more tricky. Let me show you how to add link to text or actually create a custom button. So all we're going to do is add another layer. I've already got kind of a slide started, obviously, but I want to just show you this one particular part. I'm going to add a text layer. It's going to give me the text. I'm going to say click here to learn more. And you can see it kind of start to play out here. Of course, the text, though, is white, and that it's not going to work out for me right away. But I definitely want to add a link to it. So what's the fastest way to add a link to it? Let's go ahead and change the style for a second. I'm going to click Style. Of course, I've selected this layer. I'm going to click Style. I'm going to change the color so we can see what we're working on here. Down to black, and now I can actually see my text. Good deal. Got that in place. And now I want to add an action to this bit of text. So I'm going to add an action. I'm going to click the plus sign to add an action. Then it says on click, or you have the option for when the mouse hovers over or hovers away. We're just going to say on click. We want it to go to a simple link, and then we're going to type in the link of where we'd like this button to take our visitor as they click. And I'm just going to put webtegrity.com. Of course, we want this one to open up in the same window. If you wanted them to leave your website, you can do a new window, and that actually writes all the code to make this button now clickable. So that text is now a hot link. If we want it to actually look like a button, there's some extra stuff you can do to it. Check this out. I'm going to go ahead and click on the layer again, and I'm going to go back to Style. So there's some different things we can do that you probably wouldn't know is available. I'm going to open up this little drawer next to Style. And now I can put a background on this bit of text to create it into looking something more like a button. I'm going to do background, and I'm going to change the color to something a little more comparable to our red that's already on the screen. And then I want to add a little spacing, a little padding around it. So I'm just going to put 10 on each side so that it gives it a little bit of breathing room around the text. Good, good, good. And then I am going to change the color back to white now because I think that'll look better on my button. And of course, all of this is going to still be clickable. As soon as you come over it, click on it, it's totally clickable. If you wanted to go a little bit more fun and make it have rounded corners, you can click over to border. And then you're going to put, I'm just going to use the same 10 pixels all the way around. And what you're doing is rounding the edges so that it's not a perfect rectangle. It actually has some edges around it, so it makes it look more like a button. You guys, that's it. That's how simple it is. I mean, it's not super simple because they've got all these different layers going on up here, but I hope this video helps you. If you have more questions about the Rev Slider, you can always connect with the team that made it. Theme Punch is an outstanding team. You get free support because you've purchased this. This is a premium plugin. If you have questions, though, put them in the description box below. I'll do my best to answer back. Hope y'all are having a great one. Bye, y'all.